In this video, we will show you China's newest megaproject that will replace the sun. But first, let me ask you a thought-provoking question. What if we could bring the sun down to Earth? If you find this concept implausible and unlikely to occur, China is here to challenge that belief. The country has successfully recreated the central star of our solar system by creating a nuclear sun simulation. However, it is crucial to understand the functioning of China's nuclear sun replica. Furthermore, it is prudent to contemplate whether China might be assuming a burden beyond its capacity and whether there exists a valid apprehension regarding the potential escalation of uncontrollable hazards. The sun holds a vital position within the solar system, embodying the essence of life. It stands as the predominant entity, encompassing an impressive 99.8% of the total mass of the solar system, with a diameter approximately 109 times that of Earth. The sun has the capacity to accommodate roughly 1 million planets, akin to ours. Although the outer temperature of the sun measures approximately 10,000 degrees Fahrenheit or 5,500 degrees Celsius, the sun's core harbors an immensely greater magnitude of heat, exceeding 27 million degrees Fahrenheit or 15 million degrees Celsius. In order to emulate the sun's energy production, an individual would need to trigger the explosion of 100 billion tons of dynamite every single second. Located within the expansive Milky Way, our sun, a member of the abundant stellar ensemble, rests at a staggering distance of roughly 25,000 light-years away from the central nucleus of our galactic home. Its orbital journey encompasses a remarkable span, completing a full revolution over a staggering 250 million-year period. In the context of stellar existence, the sun can be considered youthful, belonging to the population, one group of stars characterized by their abundance of elements beyond the helium. Its birth transpired around 4.6 billion years in the past, yet it possesses ample resources to sustain its radiant activity for an additional 5 billion years. The radiant power released by the sun's surface measures approximately 63 million watts per square meter. Upon traversing a distance of 150 million kilometers, or 93 million miles, this energy weakens to 1,370 watts per square meter at the uppermost layer of the atmosphere, directly aligned with the sun. Nevertheless, China seems to be discontent with the energy yield obtained from our natural star, prompting the construction of an artificial sun in its own vicinity. Astonishingly, this engineered sun exceeds the original's temperature by more than fivefold. However, such an ambitious endeavor comes with an exorbitant price tag of $1 trillion. Prior to delving into the functioning of China's artificial sun, it is crucial to understand the rationale behind its conclusion. The primary objective is to achieve an abundant and sustainable source of pristine energy by replacing the inherent reactions observed in celestial bodies. By employing a technique akin to the natural sun, this groundbreaking endeavor represents the pinnacle of clean energy generation. Notably, this innovative process eschews the use of fossil fuels and mitigates the generation of perilous waste materials, thereby distinguishing itself from the convenient nuclear fission employed in commercial nuclear energy production. Furthermore, proponents assert a significantly diminished likelihood of an ecological catastrophe. What is the functioning mechanism of China's artificial sun? It operates in a manner similar to the sun itself. The solar energy that reaches our planet is a result of nuclear fusion transpiring within the sun. Nuclear fusion takes place as hydrogen atom protons undergo intense collisions within the sun's core, leading to the formation of helium atoms, referred to as the PP or proton chain reaction. This process releases immense energy from the sun's core. Approximately 620 million metric tons of hydrogen are fused by the sun every second. The occurrence of this reaction becomes achievable due to the immense levels of pressure and temperature residing within the core. These conditions are estimated to be equivalent to an astonishing 250 billion atmospheres, or 25.33 billion kilopascals, and the scorching 15.7 million Kelvin, respectively. As a result of the fusion of our four protons or hydrogen nuclei occurs smoothly, leading to the creation of an alpha particle. This particle consists of two protons and two neutrons tightly bound together, resembling the composition of a helium nucleus. In addition, during this fusion process, two positrons and two neutrinos are released. The neutrinos play a crucial role by converting two protons into neutrons, while also producing a considerable amount of energy. China's East, also known as the Experimental Advanced Superconducting Tokamak, accomplished an impressive feat by effectively raising the temperature of a plasma loop to an extraordinary level, surpassing the sun's intensity by fivefold. This remarkable achievement persisted for a duration of over 15 minutes, during which the reactor maintained an astounding temperature of 158 million degrees Fahrenheit, 70 million degrees Celsius, for a total of 1,056 seconds. The scientific community widely commended this milestone as it signifies a substantial advancement towards the realization of a nearly limitless and environmentally friendly energy source. In 2003, EAST surpassed the achievement of France's Tour Super Tokamak by sustaining similar temperatures within a cooling loop for a duration of 390 seconds. Furthermore, EAST achieved a remarkable milestone a year ago, operating for 101 seconds at a scorching temperature of 216 million degrees Fahrenheit or 12 million degrees Celsius. Replicating the immense energy of the sun and other formidable stars presents a formidable challenge, as it entails recreating the intricate conditions found within the celestial bodies. EAST employs a tokamak configuration, which is a machine employing magnetic fields to enclose plasma in a torus-shaped structure known as a donut. Advocates of fusion energy assert that the tokamak represents the foremost concept for confining plasma in future fusion power plants. With a tokamak, magnetic coils serve to confine plasma particles, enabling the plasma to reach the requisite conditions for fusion. At the core of a tokamak lies a vacuum chamber in the shape of a donut. Within the confined area, the gaseous hydrogen fuel experiences significant levels of heat and pressure, leading to its conversion into plasma, an electrically charged gas with elevated temperatures. By employing sizable magnetic coils positioned around the chamber, scientists can manipulate the charged particles within the plasma, known as tokamak, derived from a Russian acronym referring to a toroidal chamber with magnetic coils. This control mechanism is crucial to prevent the plasma from coming into contact with the walls of the chamber. Such contact could result in a rapid, catastrophic meltdown. The vessel is subjected to a potent flow of electrical current, resulting in the ionization of gaseous hydrogen fuel. This ionization process involves the separation of electrons from the nuclei, forming a state of matter known as plasma. While the plasma particles collide with each other, they gain energy and undergo heating. Supplementary techniques are employed to elevate the plasma to fusion temperatures ranging from 150 to 300 million degrees Celsius. Consequently, the energized particles overcome their inherent electromagnetic repulsion upon collision, leading to fusion and the liberation of tremendous amounts of energy. Considering the wide range of temperatures involved, one might question the safety of tokamaks. However, it is important to note that in a modern tokamak, the chamber typically holds less than 1/10 of a gram of hydrogen fuel at any given time. In the event of a disruption during a pulse, the reaction cools down and ceases immediately, rendering a nuclear explosion within a tokamak impossible. Moreover, the fusion process itself is inherently secure. Nevertheless, scientists are taking extensive precautions by incorporating various additional safety measures into the designs of fusion power plants. Hence, even in the event of a catastrophic breach in a tokamak, the resulting levels of radioactivity outside the facility would remain extremely low. Chinese scientists encountered a significant challenge in dealing with the intense heat required for fusion. Fusion reactors necessitate extremely high temperatures surpassing those found in the sun, due to operating under lower pressures than the sun's fusion process. While heating plasma to temperatures hotter than the sun is achievable, containing it within the reactor without causing damage through lasers or magnetic fields poses an additional obstacle that could disrupt the fusion procedure. China has allocated a substantial sum of $700 billion toward the development of EAST, and it is expected to invest approximately half of that total before the experiment's completion in June. Additionally, EAST acts as an initial venture for a broader fusion endeavor known as ITER, the International Thermonuclear Experimental Reactor, presently being built in Marseille, France. The ITER initiative encompasses a cooperative endeavor comprising 35 countries, including representatives from the European Union, the United Kingdom, China, India, and the United States. Utilizing the knowledge acquired from EAST's creation, ITER now houses an extraordinarily robust magnet that boasts a magnetic field strength exceeding that of Earth by 280,000 times. The designers of ITER assert that injecting 50 megawatts of energy into the system to initiate the reactor will yield an output of 500 megawatts. Notably, the internal capacity of the ITER, tokamak, sets a new record, with a plasma volume reaching 830 cubic meters, surpassing the maximum plasma volume observed in operating tokamaks, which stands at 100 cubic meters. The vast amounts of plasma contained within ITER will allow for the unprecedented achievement of burning plasma. In this state, the fusion reaction will be sustained primarily by the alpha particles generated during the process itself, marking a significant milestone in magnetic fusion research. After over 5 decades of dedicated study, scientists will witness the realization of self-heated plasma, which has long been the objective. With the fusion reactor scheduled to become operational in 2025, it promises to provide valuable knowledge and understanding for the practical utilization of stellar energy on our planet. In principle, it is possible to extract deuterium, which consists of heavy hydrogen atoms, from the oceans of our planet. It is estimated that a single liter of seawater contains a sufficient amount of fusion material to generate energy equivalent to that produced by 300 liters of gasoline. Hence, China's artificial sun holds the potential to provide an inexhaustible source of energy. In addition to the EAST project, China is actively pursuing other initiatives to advance nuclear fusion technology, with plans to complete the construction of a new tokamak facility in the early 2030s. We would love to hear your thoughts on China's artificial sun. If you enjoyed this video, kindly give it a thumbs up. We thank you for watching today's discussion and look forward to our next video.